Hi Libra, I hope that you're doing well. I send you so much love and light. Welcome to your June love reading. So today we're going to take a look and see what is the energy like in your love life in June. Could be who's coming your way, the experiences you could have. Let's just see what comes through from spirit about your love life. I hope that you guys enjoy this reading, and if you're new to my channel, thank you so much for clicking on the video. My name is Lynn. This is Passionate Heart Tarot. Don't forget to leave a like on the video, you guys, if you like it. And if you haven't already subscribed, I do hope that you'll subscribe. Let's see what your messages are. All right, Libra, before I begin, just want to take a moment to invite the light ring of the Holy Spirit. Okay, there's going to be a shift. That's what someone here needs to know. Cancer's energy has come through and the initial M is here. Is that your initial, or maybe you're involved with a Cancer? Pisces energy has come through as well. So you guys might be cross watchers watching Libra's reading, or maybe you're involved with a Cancer or a Pisces, or you have a Cancer or a Pisces on your mind, or that could be your own moon or rising signs. So there's okay. If you're wondering if someone loves you, they absolutely do love you. This person is currently in love with you, in love with you still loves you, because I know someone is asking the question if this person still loves them. And I can see, yes, they do. But the Ace of Cups is, it's a tricky energy in a sense, because it's like everything that's being kept inside. So it wouldn't surprise me if you guys feel that whoever you're involved with now is not saying the things that you feel they really want to say. Or even if it's just as simple as this person hasn't told you that they love you yet, or some of you are wondering if this person still loves you. It's just everything that is being kept inside, and how this person's emotions go so deep. Because when I see the Ace of Cups, I know that they've never felt that way about anyone else. And I know that they're the I know that you're the love of their life. And I wonder if any of you feel that way about this person. And these are blockages for sure, because the Chariot's in reverse and the Ace of Cups is in reverse. So this shows me very clearly the way that something looks like it's at a standstill, but there's like all of this emotion and tension and just like something that's waiting to happen between you and whoever this is that you have on your mind. Or maybe it's just someone's feelings for you, Libra, and this is spirit letting you know. So the Chariot coming through in reverse, it shows me so much, because the two of you are right for each other. In so many ways, the two of you complement each other and you balance each other out. You're like yin and yang. It's beautiful. But the problem or the blockage is holding back and not saying everything that this person feels. So it feels like you're just waiting for someone to profess their feelings for you, or to call you, or to like reunite with someone. That's what it feels like. And that's why I talk about the shift and the turnaround. So with the overall energy coming through as the Hanged Man, it's the way this person wakes up and has a lot of realizations about, it's not necessarily about how they feel, because I already know this person knows that they're in love with you. It just feels like they hold back from professing everything and saying it. So this person already realizes, Libra, that they're in love with you currently. I think what they realize is their own insecurities and what makes them hold back from you from fully giving their heart and fully giving themselves over to you. I can see in June where this person comes to realize all of these things in a major way. The Hangman to me almost feels like a breakthrough, because you see the halo of light around their head when they go from kind of like being stuck to having a change of realizations, it's a halo around this person's head, which it feels very enlightening. It feels very eye-opening, heart-opening. And then when you see the Knight of Pentacles come through in reverse, it shows me that something that has either been at a standstill or completely stopped, like as if maybe some of you are not in communication with this person, or it's at a standstill and you feel like things have not progressed or move forward between you and this person in a while, all that is about to change majorly in June. So I see a huge shift and turnaround in someone's pursuit towards you, someone's actions towards you, and I think you're really gonna see this month into this person's intentions towards you. What I can see, Libra, is someone that is really stuck on you and cannot seem to release the connection or let you go. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that you like have to embrace this person, just because I can see their attempts to come back into your life. I can see that. But you know what this feels like, especially when I see this combination of cards right here? Nine of Cups, Eight of Pentacles, Three of Pentacles in reverse. This is one of the most significant ones because this is, there's going to be a switch though. Okay. So this energy is, yes, they're coming back into my life. Yes, they're putting in a lot of effort towards me. And they're really trying to show me that they want to make it up to me, that they want to make it right. They're trying to give me the justice that they feel I deserve. Well, you know what? I'm just going to soak up that energy for a little bit. I'm not going to tell them yes. I'm not going to tell them no. I'm going to just see how this feels in the present and see what this person coming back into my life is really all about. The offer is definitely going to be put out on the table. That's why that Three of Pentacles is there. And that is the offer for something serious, because it feels like almost like a contract. Something tangible for sure between the two of you that makes you see how serious this person is. They're going to lay out their intentions towards you very clearly, with what they say, but also with what they show. They're going to take all the appropriate action towards you, Libra, to make you feel like they're doing the right thing and they're doing right by you. But the Three of Pentacles in reverse shows me, yes, the offer is being made, but it's in reverse, so it's like it's not being taken. And I feel like it's not being taken because you guys want to kind of soak up what you feel you finally deserve from this person, because the Nine of Cups says a lot about the way they make you feel. Even though you're not giving them a straightforward answer, I can see where you guys enjoy this person's attention, and it makes you feel really good and it makes you feel special. So whatever this person wants to do for you to put you up on a pedestal and make you feel special, I see you guys taking that energy. I know some of you here watching have like your minds and hearts dead set on not letting anyone that you had from the past. I know some of you here are like, no, I'm done with the past. You know, some of you feel that way. But the energy that I can pick up on in this reading is, I see you embracing this. So this is a reading for those of you that would consider hearing this person out. It's not like a horrible, nasty ex that it's like, no. Because that's not what the vibe is like. The vibe is like, I want to see what they'll do. I want to see what they're all about. So I feel like I'm talking to those of you that resonate more with that energy. And I do see this person working really hard to try and make things as perfect as they can be between the two of you. They are going to be on their best behavior, and you are going to see all the effort that they put in. And you know, it's funny because that's why I'm saying that I'm talking to those of you that would consider embracing everything that this person wants to bring to you. And where I see it really puts a smile on your face and makes you feel proud. It makes you feel special. Makes you feel like it's good to have all this attention on me and be the center of attention. Because after this person puts in all the effort to make it right, the next card is the Fool. So that shows me like a progression of this person's efforts towards you and making it right actually working, where I see you taking a chance on them again. Trusting them enough to take a chance, trusting them enough to open your heart back up to this person. And it in order to embrace this energy, it feels like it's safe. So that's what I can see going on with others of you. But some of you may feel like both spreads connect and you resonate with all the energy that has come through so far in the reading. I can just see them approaching because they cannot let you go. They don't know how to let you go. I want to look at that 10 of Wands. Someone here needs to know, for whatever reason, that this person is like, if you're in separation with the way that I can see, and that's why they're coming back, you need to know that since the two of you have been separated, there has been no one that they've looked at in the same light as they look at you. Because no one can compare to you. They're so stuck on you that they can't see anyone else. Can't acknowledge anyone else. It's like they're very fixated on you and getting back together with you and wanting to make it right with you. So I know some of you here could have heard rumors that this person is with someone else. When I tap into their energy and the way that they're so stuck and fixated on you, it's like I can't see anyone else because my blinders are here and I'm just focused on getting my Libra back. No, I just have to say this again. No one can compare to you. They wouldn't dare compare anyone to you. And no one can take your place. No one has taken your place. No one ever will take your place. So I can see someone coming back into the picture in June, Libra, and doing everything that it takes to prove their love to you, to make you feel special, to make you feel acknowledged in ways that you truly deserve, because this is giving you what you deserve. I also feel like there's another message for someone here, is if you want this person to make a commitment to you, one kind of strategy that you can use in June is like not giving this person a straight answer. Because I almost feel like this energy can be flipped around. It feels like I'm talking to someone here that's dating this person now, and they feel like, I want a commitment, and they haven't asked me for one yet, and I want them to ask me for one. It almost feels like the vibe and what will get you to get the commitment that you want and you've been looking for is to kind of play hard to get. Is to let this, moreover, like to let this person pursue you and chase after you. Because what I can see is once they feel like they're able to pursue you and chase after you, which is what feels right to this person, that's when you get the kind of commitment that you want. So don't think I'm trying to be insulting towards you at all, Libra. But I feel like a straightforward message from Spirit is don't chase anyone if you're looking for a commitment. Let this person come to you, pursue you, and ask you for the commitment. Because if someone here watching feels like they want that and they haven't gotten that yet, I feel like I'm being shown a strategy from Spirit on how to get that. Maybe being a little more mysterious. Not always being so available. Keeping this person on their toes is going to get someone everything that they desire. All right, Libra, that's what I can see going on in the energy. I do hope that you guys enjoyed the reading. I love you so much. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like on the video, and I hope you'll subscribe. And I just want to say thank you again, Libra, and I will see you in the next reading.